Yes.
Hello, Kalu, I'm here to tell you something. I am very impressed that you actually passed math, science, physical education, reading and social studies. I'm surprised that you are going to kindergarten after the summer is over. I am so proud of you, son.
Oh no, father, are you sleepwalking again? What are you going to do? You better not eat my frozen pepperoni Chuck E. Cheese's pizza. I saved up all of my allowance money on buying a second one just for myself. You know that, $20, to a 4-year-old feels like a million. When you sleep what you seem to, like to eat a bunch of the food in the fridge, without remembering it.
Oh no, Kalu, thanks for waking me up. I'm going to check the fridge. I did it, note again. Wadi yahoo ha ha ha. Kalu, I'm sorry, I ate every single thing in the fridge in my sleepwalking misadventure, including your Chuck E. Cheese's pizza that you were saving for later. How can you forgive me? This is my fault.
Don't worry too much, father. Let's deal with it tomorrow morning. You owe me, though. Okay.
10 hours later.
Seriously, what a stupid TV show. Are they starting to run out of ideas on the Beyond Network? A documentary about the life of Steve the stock character? That sucks. I'm probably going to go online and find a place where I can leave a negative review.
Seriously, father, I think it actually looks pretty cool. I mean, Steve the stock character seems to be going on the most epic of adventures. He even has his own gym membership and actually shows up, unlike most people who get one. He's getting his money's worth, isn't that awesome?
Hey guys, it's Steve the stock character here. On my half a kilometer walk to the gym, I found a gift card to Vand Home Style Cafe. I checked on my Samsung Galaxy S6 and it still has $5 of the $25 of credit left. That means I'm going to be able to get their cheapest combo meal, the beloved meatball sandwich.
Don't worry, Kalu, when you grow up and develop your brain a bit, you'll realize this show sucks.
No, father, I'm set in my ways and think that it is the best show ever. I love how Steve the stock character goes rambling for 10 minutes about his favorite streaming service called VNflix. I mean, that's so entertaining.
Ha ha ha.
I'm just saying that because
I want to awaken my father's rage.
I enjoy wishing at times.
I hate that show too, kind of like watching Shiner shine instead.
Kalu, you are such a fool. You need to have a timeout. Go stand in the corner for 5 whole minutes. Maybe that will give you some common sense, and if you don't, I will have to upgrade that into a grounding. So, now what should I do? What should I watch instead?
This sucks, but, I mean, at least it isn't a grounding. Got to look on the bright side.
Hey Kalu, want to go to Peter Piper Pizza together? I'm bored and want to have some fun.
Leo, no, leave me alone. Kind of funny coming from you.
My concerned parent senses are tingling. Leo, what are you doing here? Leave at once or else I'll call your parents and have them ground you. Can't you see that my son is facing the consequences of his actions?
Oh, I don't want to get grounded. I haven't had that happen in 9 months and 16 days. I've been marking all of the days. I haven't gotten privileges restricted. Bye.
After Caillou's timeout.
So father, you said that you owed me pizza, so are you going to live up to what you said?
No, here's 2,000 cents, just for you. Can you leave me alone? I'm too lazy to go over there. I hope this cheers you up instead. Thanks for being such an obedient child.
Thank you so much. I can finally go to GameStop and get a Steam gift card to purchase a copy of Half-Life 2. Yay. That game will probably be pretty cheap. What other game should I get? I think I should purchase Elder Scrolls 3 Morrowind and Elder Scrolls 4 Oblivion. I want to be the coolest mage in Tamriel. With my level 100 enchanting ability, I only have a free copy of Elder Scrolls 2 Daggerfall on DOS box. Father, you are forgiven. Cheers.
Hey Boris, I got a weird call saying that someone wants to meet us at the Vyond Logic Hotel on 100 Strawberry Street.
What? What kind of text-to-speech voice do they have?
Simon, let's go.
Knockety, knock, knock. Hey Harold, what? Why'd you call us and tell us to meet you at a hotel room?
Guys, just come inside. I've got something a little personal to tell you. So, I was bored a few weeks ago and decided to get a DNA test done. I'm related to you. Boris, I'm your beloved Ginger second cousin.
You are serious, Wom?
Yes, I am. This is unbelievable and shocking to me, also.
So, anything else you wanted to tell me?
Yes, two more things. I was able to recover our great-grandmother's heirloom. I want to give it to you. Hang on for a second. This is our great-grandmother's wedding ring. I went through a lot of trouble to find this. It was in a dusty box at my uncle's home, in his closet. I'm surprised it's still around.
Why are you giving it to me?
Just to be nice, I guess, and I think you'd be better keeping up with it. My uncle is getting pretty old and I think I might risk losing it in my scientific adventures.
So, what was the other thing you were going to tell me?
I need someone to go on my adventures with me, and I know that you and Doris seem very stressed out. Would you like me to take Kailu off of your hands? Just Kailu, though, you will keep Rosie and Daisy still. Does that sound like an acceptable plan? He's kind of the adventurous, fun type anyways.
Boris, this sounds like a perfect idea. Our babysitter rate, when we go do fun stuff, could be lowered because there's an additional charge per child.
What Doris said, but why did you need to rent a hotel room for this? Why couldn't you have done this in your lair?
Because I just wanted it to be a surprise and felt like it, okay?
Hey Kailu, did you know that Harold is your relative? He wants to take you on his fun adventures for the rest of your summer break. That's what the three of us have decided. He's my second cousin, but I'm not sure how he's related to you because that once removed, second removed genealogy crud makes my head hurt.
So, do I have any say on this or what? I would actually much rather spend my summer playing Steam games.
No, you don't, because you can't choose for yourself yet. Come on, get in the car.
Can I at least bring my laptop?
Yes, I will let you do that.
2 hours later.
Bye Kailu, I'm going to miss you so much. I hate you a lot and like you a bunch at the same time. I will pick you up right before your kindergarten school year starts with Miss Clarkson.
Hey Kailu, what's up? Should we make a clone of you?
Not yet, please. Where is my room?
Okay Kailu, here is your room.
Okay, that looks cool. Thanks for having a room all set up for me and stuff. Back, frustrated, yawn. I hope Harold lets me play Elder Scrolls 3 tomorrow and on my laptop tomorrow morning. I wonder if he'd be the kind of person to scream the word grounded at the top of his lungs. Good morning world, I mean good morning, VVRDNFELL. I love how the boots of blinding speed helped me run around my favorite town of Narmok super fast. I am obsessed. It sucks how I can't just do this forever. I hate having to face the real life, horrid, Vyond world back. But really, what is real life? Is real life the video game? Is real life Vyond, or is real life something different even outside of this that can't be explained very well? I think I'm seeing something really weird. What is going on here? Harold, are you doing something super weird in the other room that's causing this? I hope everything is back to normal now. I just want to get to the highest rank in the Mages Guild, in peace.
Oh, hey Kailu, I was just trying to split an atom with common household materials in the other room. I could feel the air vibrating and the house shaking a bit.
Whoa, did things get pretty glitchy to you for a bit, also?
Yes, in fact, my hair turned cyan for 5 seconds and then turned back to that normal iconic ginger look.
Harold, please leave me alone, okay? I'm trying to sell my enchanted silver dagger for 129 gold, and then use that to buy some cheese for a certain quest. It's some cringy mod pack that I downloaded that allows me to do this.
Kalu, you are too obsessed over that game. That's boring and I didn't bring you here so you play Steam games non-stop.
No, this 15-year-old Elder Scrolls game is the best thing since Reward Day videos. Let me play. At least until I'm level 100 in all of my skills, that should take me at least a non-stop month of grinding every waking moment on this game. This is so much more fun than stupid schoolwork. I mean, I deserve this because I passed preschool after the 10th time I flunked it. Give me a break, second cousin, unremoved.
Second cousin, unremoved? That's a pretty mean thing to say. Kyle, you're not grounded, but there's a catch. Kyle, K-I-U. Kyle, give me your laptop at once.
No, I bet you are going to sell it like my father. And be a giant jerk.
No, I'm not. Just give it to me. I'm going to let you have it at the end of your summer break.
I can't go that long without running around Balmora doing pointless quests and leveling up my destruction skill. Give me a break.
Shut up, Kalu. Just go save your game and then give me your laptop. I thought you liked doing favors for me to get cooler perks and out of these world inventions.
Very well. I won't do that.
3 hours later. Not 3 minutes.
Kalu, I thought you were going to save your game. Why did you have to lie?
5 more minutes, please.
No, Kalu, you violated my trust. I don't care if you lose like 30 minutes of progress. Come with me, right this instant.
What are you going to do to my laptop? Is it going to be anything bad? It looks like you are going to do something upsetting.
Don't worry, you can calm down quite a bit. It's going to be only mildly upsetting.
Oh, that's great. Yay. Wait, what?
Okay, Kalu, I put your laptop in a dry ice force field. It will freeze the day before kindergarten.
Hey, if I just push the lever in the other direction, can't I just get my laptop back?
No, because, Kalu, where did the lever go? It just seemed to disappear.
Oh no, is the laptop okay at least? Will my save file be all right?
Yes, it will, chill out. Trust me, the experiment we are about to do is going to be a lot more fun than a silly, single-player role-playing game. I want you to come into the green living room with me, not the blue one.
I don't know why I'm being so resistant toward you. This should be more fun than just laying around being grounded on a boring summer's day when it looks super fun outside.
So, I'm going to do a little experiment to combine the two of you and make you one and invisible. Too bad. Shadow Kalu and Kalu. I want you to stand on the table. Point at each other and let your fingers touch. Then wait for a little bit. Now I want you guys to close your eyes and focus really hard. Think about a blank void. You can do this. It's going to be super cool. There, you are Kalu and Shadow Kalu. You are one together. You're a semi-transparent prop character. That cannot talk normally. How does that feel?
Hey Harold, I'm kind of angry because this isn't completely invisible. Can you make me invisible all the way?
Sorry Kalu, I kind of tried and failed. I've got something special for you though. I want you to stand there for about a second.
Please tell me what just happened.
I harvested the invisibility essence and, whenever you wear those rings you will become, that way kind of semi-transparent invisible.
Whoa, that's pretty awesome. I could use that to mess around with Miss Clarkson next school year. I'm just thinking about something fun I could do.
Yes, indeed. You two will get to keep that. I hope you guys enjoy. Hey Shadow Kalu, what are you doing? Get back here at once, you out of this world spawn.
The Shadow Realm is very boring, the real world is so much more fun. I mean, Fiend City has 3 different arcades. Peter Piper Pizza, Chuck E. Cheese isn't the arcade in the mall. Speak of it, I'm not human, anyways, and so what if I'm your creation? I am extremely self-aware. I must escape from your science experiment, Wraith. What? A lightsaber? Why did you get that out?
Oh my, wrong tool. Meant to bring out a wand that I can wave at you and cause you to freeze in phantom ice.
Hey Harold, second cousin, unremoved, what's phantom ice? I've never even heard of that before.
So, phantom ice physically looks like ice. It freezes the person in it and pretty much suspends their body. I was going to use my wand that spawns that to catch Shadow Kaoru.
Kaoru, seriously. If you wouldn't have asked for that explanation, Shadow Kaoru wouldn't have gotten away and I will have caught him. It's all your fault. Fool.
But you didn't have to stop to explain. Didn't you make that choice? Calm down. I can run away fast enough. The Shadow Realm is only 100 square kilometers. The Viand planet is 510 million square kilometers. The exact same amount of space that's on the regular Earth. Wow, I think that's business friendly, villain a far distance. As long as I've got my radioactive milk, I should be fine. Hello, help me please. How do I get some of that fresh and delicious radioactive milk? Walking a dozen kilometers into town really got me parched. I would really want it before I get too thirsty.
Kid, tell me, what is that? Why do you look so strange? You look even weirder than those comedy world folk.
It's something I need or else. That's what I drink to survive. I can go up to 9 days without having it before it ends up being really bad, but can you help me get it?
No, I am not going to be able to help you, but here's a glass of regular milk. I bought it and was going to bring it home with me tonight. I feel bad for you. Can you have that?
Gulp, gulp, gulp. I can't do the digestion. Help.
No, I want to go home and watch videos of logos getting into dead meat. Leave me alone, kid.
Time to check out the arcade in the mall. Maybe I could at least have some fun there. Here's some Shadow Bucks. Can you please trade these in for tokens? I want to play the mouse maze game. I was 5,000 points from getting the high score last time.
Sorry, kid. We don't accept foreign currency here. I wish I could give you tokens. We only accept business-friendly cash here. I heard that there are some arcades on the border that accept two kinds of currency.
Oh no, do you know where the nearest currency exchange center is from here? I would really like to know.
Yes, about 40 kilometers that way. The reason why there aren't that many of them is because we don't get that many tourists to business-friendly ville.
But I want lots of fun now. And my pockets are stuffed to the brim with foreign currency.
Kaoru, you're going to help me find Shadow Kaoru again or else I'm going to have to change my password on my Viand Flix account and you won't even get to watch anime.
1548 use.
Don't you dare ever make that face again or else you will face even more consequences.
So, what can I do to help you?
Go through all of my stuff in my closet and search for the thing that looks like a compass.
This doesn't look like a compass. Who keeps a pumpkin in a closet? That's kind of weird. Nope. Why does Harold need a compass and why does he have so many weird things in his closet?
Oh great, Kaoru, you found it. I've been missing that for 2 whole weeks. It's not actually a compass. It's a dark matter detector.
Explain what a dark matter detector is, well if you want to and won't yell at me about it.
Oh, I won't yell at you about it. Shadow Kaoru is likely very far away now. A dark matter detector helps us find the shadow characters and dark matter floating around. As you can see, if we open it up you can see dark matter about 3 solar systems away from us over to the left. That mass is where I get my dark matter for shadow characters. It's really difficult to get over there and that's part of the reason why I'm so controlling over my shadow characters. So come on Kaoru, the detector is telling us where to go.
So business friendly Boris, I was able to find a few dollars, got a ticket, and this bus can take me to the currency exchange center, is that correct?
Yes it is, but you are going to have to wait for 3 hours. Why are you calling me that? That's not my name and can you please leave me alone, stranger? I'm busy trying to listen to new metal music and pretending like it's 2005.
Yay, when I get to the currency exchange center and exchange it for the business-friendly cash, I can survive here. Free from Harold at last. I'm not a human and I am self-aware. He shouldn't tell me what to do.
Whoever you are blabbering way too much and it's getting on my last nerve. Next time I'm going to drive myself to my destination instead of using public transportation. Slightly more expensive, but I won't have to deal with annoying strangers.
Oh no, Caillou, what are you doing here? How did you get here? You and Harold are trying to find me with that stupid dark matter detector thing.
Bus driver, stop and lock the door. Right this instant, I need to catch my experiment.
Okay, whatever you say. I believe you.
Thank you so much.
Okay, Harold, I will get out of your way while you do this.
So, Shadow Kailu, are you ready to go back? If you don't resist, I won't freeze you in phantom ice.
I really don't want to end. Why are you so obsessive with having me? Why can't I just be on my own?
Because you're special to me and I created you. You also have to drink radioactive, milk in business-friendly vial. They don't really have any of that. Also, you are difficult to create and I care about you a lot.
No. Ha. Stop it, Harold. I want to do what I like.
Get back here at once. I offered you the easy way, but guess we are going to have to do the hard way instead.
Hey lady, let me out of the bus please. I'd need to get out on 43 Charles Street. Because that's 4 blocks from the currency exchange center.
No, because that scientist from the woods needs to get you for some reason. I am miserable working as a Comedy World bus driver, in business-friendly veal.
Come on, I know that I am not human and, like from a different dimension, but, don't you care about your customers and, customer service? I spent $10 on this fare. Let me out. I want to get away from Harold.
Well, I don't care that much because I'm making minimum wage and I'm having a really horrible day. Please don't make it worse.
Finally got him. Cheer up, Shadow Kailu. You've got to find out the good parts about being in the Shadow Realm. I mean, you fit in here a lot more than in business-friendly vial.
But there isn't that much stuff to do around here.
It's okay, here's some radioactive milk and that semi-transparent invisibility ring.
HMMM, thanks for cheering me up a bit. Do you think my father will round me if I use this? I like that experience of being semi-transparent and being combined with Caillou at the same time.
I'm not quite sure.
Slurp, slurp, slurp. Thank you, kind of.
Okay, time to go through the secret portal back to the Comedy World side of things. Don't follow me or else I'll have to take your ring away.
Okay, I accept that.
Okay, Kailu, I've got Shadow Kailu safe in the Shadow Realm. I've got the best idea for the next scientific experiment the two of us are going to do.
Oh wow, yay. What could it be? What is it?
This isn't really an experiment, maybe half an experiment, Kailu. Do you want to be a ginger?
I would love to, but I don't have any hair.
That's okay, we just have to do one extra step to make you grow hair, then if it's not that cool ginger color we will dye it. Come with me. Okay, Kailu, we are going to squirt some of the hair growth formula on your head. Then you are going to sleep for the night and wake up the next day.
I'm excited. I wonder what color my hair will be when I wake up. Wonder how it'll look. 99Z's 86U's. Whoa, I'm a girl now. What? Help, Harold, this doesn't make any sense and I'm scared. Voila.
Oh, don't worry, Kailu. You aren't a girl now because you have a male voice. You just have girl hair. The experiment went slightly off. Should we try again? Are you happy that it's the way it is?
I like this just the way it is, but I think it'd look better if I were a ginger.
Let's go make you back ginger then. Okay, so, are you sure you want the natural red color?
That is correct, uncousin. Yes.
Okay, Kailu, now wait and stand there in complete silence for 2 seconds. Thanks to Beyond Logic, that will make your hair get dyed.
Whoa, I look so weird. Now what are we going to do? It's not the typical kind of hair growth on other users' channels.
I'm going to show you my collection of 4 Beyond Sabers. Now, it's not what you expect, come on.
Seriously, Harold, is this going to be another stupid spoof on Behavior Card Day videos?
No, Kailu, this is a semi-magnetic, semi-magic board. I attach my Vyond Sabers onto. Vyond Sabers are for something really weird that I want to show you. Point a duplicate and select the one you want. The yellow Vyond Saber makes you 10 times lighter. Say if you weigh 45 kilograms, now you will weigh 4.5 kilograms. That makes it so you can jump super high. And kind of just like float around a little bit and stuff, it makes your body like a feather as long as you got that equipped. Why don't you try it out?
That was cool. Next Vyond Saber.
This is the purple Vyond Saber. When it's equipped in your inventory, that makes you run super fast, but unlike the boots of blinding speed in your game, you can't hear. This is the red Vyond Saber. When you have it in your inventory, it spawns floating hearts, which fill up your health bar.
Yay, this is great. I'm healed, somewhat.
Here's the last Vyond Saber. It just causes a cool looking ice cosmetic effect. It's the blue one.
I'm getting tired and it's dark outside. Yon, hope you understand.
Me too, Kailu. Hope we get to do something fun and amazingly different tomorrow.
Yeah. I am free from Caillou's head at once. I hated being there. He never should have brushed his hair with that enchanted brush that Goblin left laying around. The Goblin who lives next door from here. I'm going to try to get my revenge on Harold. I wish I could be put back into the hair growth formula bottle, but that would be kind of like unbaking a cake, something that's impossible. Ha ha ha, I am evil hair. Caillou deserves no hair because that's his classic look. He looks better that way. Harold is going to get such a surprise in the morning. Hey, boy hair. You've been sitting there for 29 years in the same hairstyle. All that guy's life. Aren't you getting tired of that?
Why does that cloud look weird? Is Shadow Kailu riding a cloud out of the shadow dimension? This doesn't make any sense. I'm not sure if this is a dream or not.
Hey, other set of hair, you don't need no scalp. Come on. Go somewhere else.
But where could an unwanted set of hair even imagine to go?
I don't know. I think you'd find friendly company in Harold's fur pelt closet.
Well, okay. That's a start. Hey.
Yes, the scalp is free for me at last. Now I can trigger him when he wakes up.
Whoa, this is so weird. Why did I just hear a slightly loud noise and why does my head itch all of a sudden? Mel, I'm just too tired to worry about it at this moment.
What's that pretty light coming out of the window? I haven't seen that in such a long time. I think this is the second Aurora Borealis I've seen in my entire life. This looks pretty neat. I want to go outside and look at it closer. Maybe I should take a picture of it on my smartphone and share it with my mother and father. Whoa, that is so pretty. Time to snap a 480 resolution image of this.
Kailu, explain to me why I look like this. I thought this hair was supposed to be on my head. Why are you bald again? Oh wow, the sky looks really pretty this early morning.
Harold, I'm not sure what we should do about this or how I can help. I think we just woke up like this today.
That's okay, we will just go to the salon in the mall. Did you know that they are going out of business next month and, because of that, they are charging 30% of the regular price?
Yeah, that sounds great. Let's go get it back to how it used to be.
Welcome to Sassy Lady Salon, a family-owned company. We appreciate the 35 years of support, but unfortunately this is coming to an end. We are celebrating by charging a third of our usual price. What service would you guys want? I can do almost anything. I am very experienced.
Cut my hair short, please, and make his hair look like how mine currently is now.
Sounds good, I will do that to the both of you. You are probably going to be my last customer ever because business is super rare around here.
But lately, do you have instant hair growth shampoo at least?
Yes, I do. What part of experience don't you get? Ha.
2 hours later. Okay, Kailu, now that we are looking back to the way we want, I've got another thing or seven up my sleeve that we can do. Oh no, that's not what I meant by up my sleeve. What does this say, HMMMM? There's a ship, 30 kilometers away, and some words, in a font size too small that I can't read it. Kalu, are you able to read it?
No, unfortunately not. I wish I could. Wonder what they mean by that. Should we go outside and look around?
We could, but we wouldn't know where to look, because there are a lot of possible directions in the 30 kilometer radius.
Well, a ship is likely going to be in water. We have to look for water. That would be a clue. And I also feel like the end logic will help us guide our way. Do you have a method to detect a boat? Any of your inventions in your closet that are able to do that?
Unfortunately not. And by the way, why would we even care about finding the boat in the first place?
Because that note just seems so random, and I love a good mystery of some sort.
You know what, Kalu? You've cheered me up and have gotten me motivated into doing this. Oh, here's the ship. Wonder who left that note? Or why they anchored their ship here?
Hey Harold, come on, let's go exploring the ship. Wonder why there was a glitchy kind of teleporting that was so instant. Haha. I told you that the end logic would help us find the way.
Hey guys, it's Warren Cook here. I've got a pet, friendly talking lion, here, and I am willing to trade my stash of gold coins for blank VHS tapes. They're really hard to find.
They don't even look like a lion. That's stupid.
That's because she's lying a little bit. She's a creature that's half lion and half a weird little peeps character. The conversion from prop character to little peeps went wrong.
I want to watch Beauty and the Beast, real not fake 1956 edition, while the two of us act like sailors and sail from the port of Destin, Florida to the port of Swakopmund, Namibia. Maybe we could find an expert lion tamer somewhere in Africa to help us bring some more lion buddies on our adventures.
But Warren Cook, thought your father wouldn't allow you to do things like this.
But the cool thing is I'm over 18 now. He has no authority over me anymore.
No fair. Why do you get to age but I don't?
Because I'm a beyond depiction of a real life person. Caillou, you aren't real.
Hey Harold, should we help Warren Cook, or not?
I think we should. But, will that make us bad users?
I don't know, but who cares if we end up being bad users for helping him? It's just something we could do.
Hey Warren Cook, do you know the nearest gold and silver shop from here? Because this isn't going to be worth it unless if they're ill. Let's go get them tested.
Yes, I know, guys. Come on.
Wow, this gold is real. I'm willing to buy it for spot price. I mean, precious metal dealers have to make a slight profit, you know, to like survive and stuff.
No, Albert, thanks for testing it. Here's $10. Have a nice day.
Ah, that's a shame. Thank you, I am so tired and payday isn't for 2 more weeks and I'm broke. Now I can go buy some coffee.
Harold, where are we?
This is my uncle's house. It's also your and my father's great-grandparents' house, when he was still around. Did you know he was obsessed over his VHS player, back in the 80s?
Hey, Uncle Tony, do you know where my great-grandparents' VHS collection is? May I have it?
Yes, you may. I haven't seen you in such a long time. It's exciting to have you drop by for a change.
Hey Tony, what's your favorite VHS movie? Not those fake VHS openings, but tell me please.
I'd have to say, either 101 Dalmatians, or the Rugrats movie. Those are my two favorite, but I haven't watched a single VHS movie since like 2006.
Hey Tony, are you sure that you don't want any favors done in exchange for the VHS tapes?
Was going to say no, but I actually made a huge mess in the kitchen when I dropped my mac and cheese freezer dinner. If you could clean it up, that would be really nice of you. You're actually doing a really big favor getting rid of those VHS tapes, because the collection is so huge that the garbage man won't take it.
4 hours later.
Okay, Kalu, we've got about $3,400 from selling the gold. Because of my appreciation for this, I've decided that I want to do something special for you.
Oh, I know what you could do for me that's completely free. You could give me my laptop and let me play Morrowind for the rest of the summer.
No, Kalu, you need to snap out of it and get back into the real world. Don't you know that video games suck? I know of a gift that would serve you better.
Hey, that's a stupid opinion. I don't respect it one bit.
I respect that you don't respect my opinion, but I know of something that would both make us happy. Here's the best gaming PC ever with 500 free Steam games.
Hey wait, is there a catch to this? Someone in the comments section is currently typing, hey why is that personal computer floating at insert timestamp here? There you go, that looks a lot better.
Yes, there's a catch. You can't play this until summer is over. Is that a deal?
Yes it is, that sounds good. Let's go fishing at the pond, close to here. Didn't you go down to the county tax office sometime within the past 9 months because, that's how long they last and, they cost a grand total of $50 to get a fishing license. I'm in the mood for fresh fish.
Yeah, I think it'd be a good time to because, my fishing license expires in 30 days. Did you know that thanks to Beyond Logic and my wacky science experiments there's lots of, weird, species of fish that don't exist in real life?
Yes, let's do this.
This is going to be great, Kailu. I have a big freezer that we can put a bunch of the fish in, that would probably last me a year.
It looks kind of weird out here. Is this drawn by someone who can't draw very well? What's going on?
Ah, Kailu, don't think about it. Let's just enjoy our little fishing fun.
Hey Harold, why are we using cheese as bait? That's kind of weird.
Because I did a little experiment a long time ago and, that's the best non-traditional bait, to catch fish. After 10 different trials.
Wow, what's this fish called?
This is called the greeny, meany, weird name for a fish, I know. I learned about that in a gonomat logic class, in, college that I took for leisure purposes. In the species unit of that class. They haven't updated the name of their class to be called Beyond yet, I guess they're slow to the adjustment.
Wonder what fish we will catch next. I am anticipating the experience. Windows Experience Edition.
Kyle, if you dare blurt out something random again I am going to have to ground you.
But second cousin unremoved. That's very unoriginal and boring. Stop it or else I'm going to have to cry to my mother about it over my text messages.
Fine, you win on that part, but I may still have to do something to discipline you. Like make you stare at a tree for 3 minutes with no fun. Maybe kind of like an alternative timeout but, nature themed. So, if you dare blurt out something random again I am going to have to do that. This is your first and only warning.
Oh wow, Harold, can you explain this fish?
This is called the black-boned, semi-transparent fish. It's uncommon and, I heard that it tastes like chicken for, some weird reason.
This one looks odd, the color of it kind of blends into the pond a bit. Tell us about it.
This is called the Swiss primary, color fish. It has a slight minty aftertaste. It's called Swiss, because it's found mostly, in imaginary Switzerland.
8 hours of fishing later.
Thank you, Kailu. Now I have enough fish to last me for a very long time. Now it's time for us to go into the portal room.
What's the portal room? Please tell me.
It's where we use my wand made out of obsidian, mercury and dark matter to open up various portals to different dimensions.
Why do you have that television right there in your portal room?
Oh, that isn't a television. This is my limited edition 1995 Hot Wheels CRT monitor. Only 200,000 copies were produced.
It doesn't look the part. Anyway, let's just get to the point already.
So, Kailu, what you are supposed to do is position your comedy world character like this, and think about a pretty field of flowers. Then a ray of lightning should come out. See, Kailu, I opened up a portal, look by the door. It's a portal to one of the 9,356 alternate dimensions.
Oh, you think you are cool for referencing a meme from a time super duper long ago? Do me a favor and time travel to 2005 and stay there forever, please. Leave your smartphone behind too. Stop it, old man.
Kailu, stop taking things out of context. Okay, this is one of the 9,356 dimensions of the Grand Multiverse. No one knows if there's anything beyond that. I don't know what's in here, but it's time to explore it.
Hi, my name is 800 kilogram bottle of nail polish. Hey Harold, I haven't seen you here since 2013. Welcome back to the Prop Dimension. Portable oven baked us up all a surprise.
Introducing the gelatin brick cake, inspired by Legos and only available in the Prop Dimension for a limited time.
Wow, this slightly looks like missing, no, from the Generation 1 super old Pokemon games.
I like it because it tastes like a giant green apple gummy bear. But it's a little spicy. I wonder what pepper that spice is from. Just that sweet and spicy mix really reminds me of that one time I had Mexican candy.
Hey Kailu, I think that spice is either from habanero peppers or cayenne peppers. Whatever it is, it's very delicious.
Now that we've all had our food and are all filled up. Hey Harold, do you know of a dimension I could find a giant lady who could use me? To put on her nails?
No, but here, you get to keep a copy of my dimensional wand. This is a gift for the meal you guys gave us. Thank you, have a nice day. Come on Kailu, let's go back to my lair and use the dimensional wand and check out somewhere else. Okay Kailu, the red portal wand takes us to a random one of the dimensions and the dark one takes us to the shadow dimension. The prop dimension portal is closing up. Want to spawn in the next dimension?
Yes, that sounds like a plan. Whoa, that's a really weird looking dimension. What do you think could be in there?
I have no idea, but whatever it is, it looks pretty interesting. Time to go inside.
Hello interdimensional characters. This is the vending machine dimension. Here we get everything we need for our daily life out of vending machines. We are all stick men and women here. Near the dimensional portal we have the regular soda and snack machines. Follow me for the other ones. This is our medallion vending machine. Here in the vending machine dimension medallions are a fashion statement. As a courtesy I will spend my currency and buy you each one.
These look pretty neat. What are they made out of?
They are made out of really hard compressed glass. Here in the vending machine dimension we exchange non-physical services for stick bucks. Then on every Wednesday of the week we go to one of the shops with tons of various vending machines to exchange our stick bucks for physical goods. Since this dimension is futuristic, most of the physical goods are produced by robots slash machinery. This is our jawbreaker vending machine with various different flavors. My favorite of these is the purple strawberry milk blend one.
Oh, that's cool, kind of like a candy shop in a vending machine. Are we allowed to try some of them?
I wish I wasn't so broke and could afford to get some of those. I've got a different idea. Do you guys want my last bit of stick bucks as a souvenir?
No, it was nice talking to you, but we're going to go to a different dimension now. Okay, Kailu, wonder what dimension this will be. Kailu, I want you to guess what this dimension will be like.
It'll be full of red hoodie guys who are obsessed over cheese.
Well, we won't know until we jump into it. Now, it looks like space behind us, but we don't feel weightless and we're able to breathe. This is kind of odd.
Hello, is there anyone there?
Guys, this is just a weird wallpaper we have in our house. That looks very realistic. Come follow me into one of the other rooms.
How did you teleport so instantly like that?
Orange magic that I learned in puppy training class at the Pet Smart on Blackberry Street.
Orange magic, what? Anyway, let's check out the other room of your house.
The other room of your house looks like a classroom, that's kind of odd. What are we going to do here?
We are going to wait for the purple dog to come and educate us about the various dogs throughout our solar system.
Hey Harold, him having his room school themed makes me feel pretty uneasy. Can we please get out of here?
Very well. I agree with you. Hey Kailu, summer is almost over. Is there anything final you want to do? Oh yeah, here's your gaming computer and semi-transparent invisibility ring.
Well, I really hate continuity, so can we get rid of my hair?
Yes, go step on the blue and green platform in my warehouse, that should make it go away.
Yes, I'm back to normal.
Hey Kailu, I'm back to pick you up. We got to have a nice 4-day vacation to the beach 300 kilometers away from Beyond City, and the babysitter charged us $10 less a day because you weren't around.
Hey class, my name is Miss Clarkson. This is alternative elementary school for troublemakers who've repeated preschool at least 3 times. Let's see if you can pass kindergarten within 3 attempts. I'm going to go get today's worksheet to pass out for the first day of school. Okay, introduction to the class short 200 word essay.
Why do you look like Rosie but you're kind of off?
I'm the Rosie from someone else's video.
Hello, I'm Evil Bongo, U-T-T-P, and I got held back a whole bunch of times. I've also been sent to the audience 10 times this week.
Hey Doris, do you think our kids will ever grow up? It was so nice not dealing with Kalu for an entire summer.
I have a faith that the floating timeline will have a glitch or two one of these days. Yeah, I feel like it might. We may have to wait 150 more floating timeline years for something like that to happen.
150 years? What?
Because that's how many total hours of content there is, if you combine all of the Kalo Vyond videos on YouTube.
How did you come up with that statistic? How do you know?
I don't, I just spewed that out of my lips with too much lipstick on them. Just random guess.
Hey guys, I'm broke this week and don't have that much food. Can I have some of yours?
Sure, help yourself. This is what you get for taking Kalu off of our hands for several months. It feels good connecting with distant relatives. Enjoy our big family pack of 96 cheese sticks. You can take the whole thing.
That's so nice of you guys. Maybe I will invite you to my family reunion.